Elon Musk's insane nuclear rocket astonishes scientists. Humans have long been driven to discover nature's hidden mysteries. The desire to innovate and explore the planet and beyond will never die. The same thirst has driven humans to the moon, robots to Mars, humanity to the stars. Who could have predicted that mankind will leave this planet to explore galaxies and other universes and beyond? In this video, we'll show you how Elon Musk's latest nuclear rocket stunned the entire space industry. To ensure that you never miss another video from us, please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon. Let's get this started. Today we can observe how far humanity has progressed. To put everything into perspective, the moon is only 384,400 kilometers away. The Voyager spacecraft is located in a dark, cold, desolate neighborhood towards the outer edge of our solar system. One spacecraft is about to break another record by becoming the longest traveling space probe farthest away from home. Voyager 1 was launched on February 17, 1998, more than two decades ago. It will pass the Pioneer 10 spacecraft and become the farthest distant human-made object at 10.4 billion kilometers in space. The radioisotope thermoelectric generators used by the isotope probes rely on natural decay to create heat from plutonium. Radioisotope thermoelectric generators are not nuclear reactors because they have no moving parts. Only a few hundred watts of power are produced. However, as plans for journeys deeper into our solar system rise, considerably larger vessels will be required. Nuclear power plants powered by increasingly powerful nuclear reactors are once again on the table. Companies such as NASA and SpaceX are currently on a mission to explore different worlds. Their primary interest is undoubtedly the Red Planet, to which they have dispatched robots to search for any evidence of life or water, as well as monitoring the environment for human settlement. Humanity is about to enter a new era of space travel to Mars. Interplanetary missions could be possible when nuclear power and related technologies progress faster, more efficiently, and more cost-effective. SpaceX, the world's largest technology business, is on a mission to establish a human colony on Mars. Elon Musk, the company's CEO, tweeted, "I'd rather die on Mars, but not on this planet." Elon has accomplished anything a man can consider. However, the fundamental issue that giant space organizations like NASA and SpaceX face is the capacity to go great distances in a short amount of time. It currently takes nearly 6 months to reach the Red Planet. SpaceX's existing Starship can carry a lot of cargo, but it lacks the capacity to go long distances and is not very effective. Spending nearly 6 months in transportation entails numerous risks. Astronauts will be exposed to harmful radiation that can cause long-term health concerns, including cancer as well as organ malfunction. The spaceships do have shielding mechanisms, but they're incredibly heavy. The more shielding necessary, the longer the travel. As a result, the most efficient method to address all of these hazards is to move quicker. There are currently no plans for a human expedition to Mars. However, even expedition missions must travel faster to their destinations. Voyager 2, for example, took nearly 12 years to reach Saturn. This delayed research and exploration of various planets by a decade. Three things are critical for traveling across space: thrust, mass efficiency, which is the amount of thrust produced by a given amount of fuel, as well as energy density. So how does a nuclear spaceship get its power? Nuclear technology was first used in spacecrafts back in the 1950s. NASA has started looking at nuclear thermal propulsion systems. Due to a number of setbacks, this technology was unable to be fulfilled to its full potential. Chemical propellants are used in conventional rockets to generate the requisite thrust. Rockets that burn fuel in solar-powered electric propulsion systems are also used. Chemical propulsion is the most common, but it has a significant disadvantage. It must carry a huge amount of fuel for the journey, limiting its ability to traverse large distances. Although solar-powered propulsion systems are efficient, the thrust produced is quite low. A solar-powered system, for example, can only provide enough push to propel an automobile. It takes around 2.5 hours to go from 0 to 60 miles per hour. We don't want to travel to Mars in a spaceship with such thrust-generating capabilities. Elon Musk has finally revealed a viable option. That is nuclear thermal propulsion, sometimes known as nuclear-powered propulsion. It has the potential to significantly reduce travel times to remote locations while enhancing launch flexibility and making astronaut spaceflight safer. The energy density of uranium fuel is tremendous. A small amount of uranium can substitute for thousands of liters of fuel. What is the operation of the nuclear thermal propulsion system? What are the benefits and drawbacks? Let's get into the specifics. Rockets launching from Earth will be dependent on the foreseeable future on chemical fuels. Once in orbit, however, nuclear engines may take over and provide propulsion to accelerate spaceships traveling across space. A nuclear fusion reactor warms a liquid propellant such as water in nuclear thermal propulsion hydrogen. Heat causes the liquid to turn into a gas, which expands through a nozzle to create thrust as well as propel a spacecraft. Astronauts' exposure to cosmic radiation is reduced when their time in space is reduced. The spaceship would use less fuel to reach space, resulting in substantially shorter voyage times. When compared to ordinary chemical rockets, this would reduce travel time to Mars by 25%. Rockets with propellant nuclear electric propulsion is another option. The requisite thrust is generated when thermal energy from a nuclear reactor is turned into electric energy in the system. This reduces the need for propellant storage. The thrust generated is less, but continuous, and the fuel efficiency is significantly higher. When compared to traditional methods, it has the potential to cut travel time to Mars by 60%. Rockets made of chemical nuclear reactors would be ideal for providing astronauts with extraterrestrial surface electricity. It would give explorers a consistent source of surface power for extended exploration missions. For a limited time, the nuclear reactor can generate electricity in the tens of kilobits range from one to several decades. In addition to thrust, the spaceship would require a limitless quantity of electric power to operate systems for life support, communications, and other gear. Surface power reactors based on fusion are microreactors that could produce the required power for an extended period of time. Because the distance to Mars is so great, having adequate fuel to reach, return, or abandon the mission is critical. A mission to Mars is critical. The majority of the fuel in a chemical rocket is used during the start of the mission. This is due to the engine's need for a vast amount of fuel to break free from Earth's gravity. This suggests that a spaceship destined for Mars will not have enough fuel to return to Earth if the mission must be aborted by the crew. Astronauts would not have to worry about fuel on a nuclear-powered spaceship. After several months on the road, the nuclear spaceship would still need a lot of fuel to land on Earth. The spaceship would be heavier than standard chemical-powered rockets. When we think of a nuclear spaceship, the spaceship would be heavier than standard chemical-powered rockets. When we think of a nuclear spaceship, the first thing that comes to mind is it secure? Even a nuclear spaceship would always have liquid propellants between the engine and the spacecraft. The control panel will lessen the impact of radiation. Aside from that, the distance between the engine and the crew compartment will reduce the radiation effectiveness. It has already increased considerably. A buffer shield is built within the nuclear reactor to absorb radioactive radiation. Aside from that, the reactor's fuel will be enclosed and secured. However, because the spaceship will be launched from Earth, how can the radiation be contained? SpaceX has already devised an ingenious solution. Elon Musk wrote in a tweet about a nuclear-powered spaceship. To be clear, good for in-space travel, but not for Earth orbit. As a result, until it reaches orbit, the spaceship will use chemical propellants. The nuclear engines will then start up. In the event of calamity, the fragments will not hit the ground for tens of thousands of years. The radioactive substance would not be hazardous by then. Nuclear spaceships appear quite promising, but space organizations would still have to put in a lot of effort to fix issues in this system. SpaceX has yet to determine whether to fully support this advancement as nuclear spaceships. Because of the potential risks, it could not be reused. However, NASA intends to launch nuclear-powered spaceships into orbit by 2026. NASA also intends to provide enough fuel for a crew chemical rocket to reach Mars. The fuel for the return voyage would have to be supplied to Mars ahead of time or built utilizing Mars's resources. A moon mission using nuclear-powered spaceships would be an excellent reconnaissance mission for agencies in space. This would allow agencies to test the system's efficiency before launching it to Mars, creating self-sustaining conditions on the moon with nuclear energy and monitoring human activity. Conditions are critical before embarking on the years-long voyage to Mars. If a practical fusion reactor can be created, a nuclear-powered ship could be on its way within this century from our near cosmic proximity to the stars and planets. Comment here with your opinions on Elon Musk's ridiculous nuclear-powered spaceship in the box below. And if you enjoyed this content, please subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.